In this video, I'm going to show you how to set up a Salesforce merchant account. You might have a situation where your staff is even writing credit card numbers down on a piece of paper, or they're just leaving Salesforce to go to some other system to take payment. And you've realized that you want all of those payments taken directly inside of Salesforce. If we haven't met, I'm Micaiah, and I'm one of the co-founders here at Chargent. The Chargent team made a special checklist for you on 10 ways to make Salesforce payments safe, easy, and profitable. And you should download it now. You might be asking, why do I want to set up a Salesforce merchant account? Well, there's a bunch of different reasons why you may want this. So first off, merchant accounts, they're actually global in nature, meaning that a single account, it can be used in many different ways for many different services at your organization. So you don't actually really need to set up a separate Salesforce merchant account per se. You could get an additional merchant ID or merchant account, and this would enable you to see all of your Salesforce transactions broken out in a particular group. And this could also be useful if you have a sales channel where you've got a lot of chargebacks and you want to isolate those from your Salesforce sales channel. Another reason that you would want to do this inside of Salesforce is to keep all of your staff in a single place, right? So your team's not moving about, checking a bunch of different systems to figure out who's paid what. When you're trying to run a business, it's easier to have all of your data in the same streamlined system. So you can run a single dashboard and see everything that's going on inside your business. All right, before you begin, it's important that you realize that we're not actually talking about a separate merchant account. A lot of folks use the merchant account that they have today. So maybe you're processing with TSYS, First Data, Braintree, or PayPal Merchant Services. And if you're processing with one of them, then you could keep them as your processor and simply move them onto Salesforce with you. So also notably, merchant banks, they go by a few different names. You could hear them called payment processor, ISO, payment facilitator. For the purposes of this discussion, and generally speaking, they're all the same. Now, of course, there are some nuanced differences between them, and it's just not useful for this particular conversation today. But quick level set here, merchant account, it's literally the thing that allows you, the merchant, to move money from the buyer's account to your checking account. Now, there is another service involved in this process, and that is the gateway. An important thing to realize is that when you're talking about working in Salesforce, or really any software system, any cloud system, or any e-commerce system, what you're really talking about is having the gateway that sits in front of the merchant account. So let's dive a little bit deeper. All right, this graphic shows how the money flows. So you've got a credit card issuer. Let's think Capital One, what's in your wallet? The idea is to put the money into you, the merchant's depository bank account. Now for depository banks, think Chase or maybe your local credit union. The idea is that you're trying to get the money into your checking account, where you pay the bills for your organization. So what happens in a system like Chargent or any e-commerce system like Salesforce Commerce Cloud, for instance, is that the system passes the data to the payment gateway. Now the payment gateway in turn, they coordinate through integration with the rest of the payment network system, including the payment processor and the card network. So card networks, think Visa and MasterCard. In short, this graphic shows how a payment flows from starting in a system like Chargent and gets all the way to your bank account. Simple, right? No, of course it isn't. I certainly believe it should be, but alas, it is not. If you do already have a merchant account, then it's likely as simple as giving them a call and just ask them to give you a gateway account that you're going to use with Salesforce. You might also ask them while you have them on the phone if it makes sense for you to have a different merchant ID to send Salesforce payments through. So, what do you do if you don't already have the merchant account? Let's talk through these steps. Step number one, you want to choose a merchant bank that you want to work with. And so some examples are TSYS, Worldpay, First Data, and PayPal Merchant Services. Step number two is to procure your company's financials. The underwriters at the merchant bank, they're going to want to understand your profit and loss as well as your balance sheet. Step three, if you're not a publicly traded company, your owners, they're gonna need to give some personal information for KYC or know your customer regulations. Now, this is a law that minimizes money laundering. And although it may seem a little invasive, as you're working through it, it really is for the best. All right, step number four. Once you've been approved by underwriting, they're gonna give you a gateway account and send you a sheet with all the information that you need to start taking payments. And here is a bonus tip. What you wanna think about is how are you gonna balance technology versus pricing versus services when you're selecting a merchant account. So the technology part, that really has to do with finding a gateway that fits your business. So if you're selling in a B2B model, you want a gateway that optimizes your transaction data to get you lower rates. If you're a business to consumer model, you probably want to think more about a system like CyberSource or Braintree, folks that have been engineered towards high volume, low latency responses. And frankly, I feel like there's a lot of good options out there for the B2C world. The next thing to look at is pricing, which is primarily what comes from that merchant account we've been talking about. But pricing, it's not the only thing to think about, of course, although it is tempting, right? Now, I do argue that, frankly speaking, payment processing itself has become quite commoditized. Again, at the end of the day, they're basically transferring money. So remember, you are negotiating based on basis points, very small increments of money. Likely the most important thing to consider is customer service, because some of the biggest players in the space, they struggle to give smaller merchants good service. And that's really where the independent sales organizations or ISOs of the world can provide great value. They might not be the least expensive, but they can take great care of you. Okay, I want you to check out the next video here, and where I'm gonna show you how to set up Chargent. My name is Micaiah, and I'm from Chargent, where we are dedicated to helping Salesforce customers like you keep payments simple. So head over to this video and I'll see you there. Remember, at Chargent, we are always here to help.